So we continue with exercise 12.2 and we are on the tens sum now. So if you see the tens sum, it is based on two digit numbers. Now before we start this particular sum, I would like to explain you a certain basic concept about the two digit numbers. Now for example, suppose I take the number 72. And the same way, if I take consider that let the units place be x and the tens place. This is a units place and this is a tens place and x place be y. Can I say the number is nothing but yx? No, I cannot say the number is yx, right? Because I am not saying that this is 72 as 72. I am not saying a 7. Now 72 is written as 70 plus 2. It is multiplied with the tens place and accordingly it is going to be, so this is the place value, not the face value. Face value is x, is 7, same way face value is y, face value is 2, here it is x, but here it is the place value. 7, which is on the tens place, becomes 70. Right, so that's why it is 70 upon 2. Accordingly, if I write this number in the same format, I will be writing it as 10y plus x. Okay, so remember this thing. Whenever you are writing any two digit number, digits nahi, we are talking about the number. The number when you are using, it will always be 10x plus y or 10y plus x, depending upon what is x and what is y. If the tens place is x, it will be 10x plus y. If the tens place is y, it will be 10y plus x. So, when you are writing the number, it will be 10x plus y or 10y plus x. But if you are taking the digits, if you are only talking about the digits will be x and y. The digits are x and y. Digits are nothing but the face value of that number. What is the face value of this number? 2. What is the face value of this number? 7. What is the place value of this number? 2 only, because the units place. What is the place value of this number? It is 70. Got it? So this is what is very, very important when you understand any particular sum based on the two digit numbers. So let's see the sums. The first sum, that is from number 10. The digits of a two digit number differ by 3. Okay, it is differing by 3. If the digits are interchanged and the resulting number is added to the original number, we get 143. What can be the original number? Okay, so what we'll do is that, first of all, we'll take let units place, or we can take tens place. Kuch farak nahi padta, theek hai. We'll take units place is equals to x. Now, we are told that the digits are differing by 3. That means the other number will automatically be x plus 3. So therefore, tens place digit is equals to x plus 3. So it is differing by 3. Yani kya? Dono ke bich mein 3 ka difference hai. X and x plus 3. You can also take x minus 3. They are not wrong because they are just given differing by 3. So you can always take my x minus 3 and x also. Not a problem. Okay. Answer will also come the same. Don't worry. Whatever you want to take, you take. I normally avoid minus signs. That's why I've taken it as x and x plus 3. So accordingly, you can see that if the digits are interchanged, the resulting number is added to the original number. So now, first of all, with this thing over here, we have over here that original number is equals to 10 x plus 3 plus x. 10 into the tens place number plus x, okay, 10y plus x, okay. So this is nothing but 10x plus 30 plus x, so it is 11x plus 30. Now, digits are interchange. Interchange yani kya? 72 ka 27 kar diya. So what will happen? Digits reversed, we have the number is equals to 10x plus x plus 3. So So it will be 10x plus x plus 3. So it will be 11x plus 3. Now I'm told that the sum of these two is 143. So it is given that 11x plus 30 plus 11x plus 3 is equals to 143. So it is 22x plus 33 is equals to 143. 22x is equals to 143 minus 33. So x 22x is equals to 110. X is equals to 110 upon 22. That will be 5 times. So x is equals to 5. Or we'll just write over here. Therefore x is equals to 5 and x plus 3 is equals to 8. Therefore original number is equals to 85. Okay. If you would have taken the other way around, you can get 58, but doesn't matter, 85 or 58, both will sum up to be the same number as the 143. So that's why original number is 85 as per our data. If you have interchanged this thing, you have made it as x minus 3, you will get it as 58, then also not a problem. Don't worry about this thing. Okay. So the answer is, that's why if you see in the backside also, they are given both the answers, 85 as well as 58. So that was sum number 10. We now move on to sum number 11. Okay, sum number 11. Sum of the digits of two digit number is 11. So sum of our digits is 11. So if let units digit be x, therefore tens digit is equals to 11 minus x. See, they are given you the sum of the two digits is 11. So agar ek samjho 8 hai to dusra kya ho gaya? 11 minus 8 3, right? एक अगर 5 है तो दूसरा क्या हो गया 11 माइनस 5 6. सो अकॉर्डिंगली यू विल टेक द अदर नंबर एज 11 माइनस x बिकॉज दे आर गिवन यू दैट द सम ऑफ द टू डिजिट्स इज 11. सो यू आर गोइंग टू टेक द अदर नंबर एज 11 माइनस x, नॉट x माइनस 11. रिमेंबर दिस थिंग, 11 इज अ ग्रेटर थिंग. 11 इज द सम ऑफ द टू नंबर्स, दैट्स व्हाई इट्स 11 माइनस x एंड नॉट x माइनस 11. राइट? सो व्हेन इट वाज गिवन द डिफरेंस, एट दैट टाइम वी एडेड x plus 3, x and x plus 3. Here it is a here it is given the sum, so you are subtracting. Got it? Again, the same thing if the numbers are digits are reverse. So again, the same thing. First thing is, therefore, number is equals to 10 into 11 minus x plus x. So it is equals to 110 minus 10x plus x. So it is equals to 110 minus 9x. Okay, that's the number. Now on interchanging, so this is the interchange, so ye idhar aur ye idhar. So what will happen? Number is equals to 10x plus 11 minus x, so it will be 10x minus x is equal to 9x, so 9x plus 11. So that's the number on interchanging. Now what is given to you? That when we interchange, it is found that the resulting number is greater than the origin number by 63. So this is greater than this by 63. So this minus this is 63. So it is 9x minus plus 11 minus 110 minus 9x is equals to 63. Got it? So we open the brackets here. So it is 9x plus 11 minus 110 plus 9x is equals to 63. So this adds up to 18x minus 199 is equals to 63. So 18x is equals to 63 plus 99. So 18x is equals to 162. So x is equals to 162 upon 18. This is 9s. So x is equals to 9. Therefore, tens units is equals to 9. Tens is equals to 11 minus 9 is equals to 2. Therefore, number is equals to 29. Okay? So, the two-digit number what you are talking about is 29. You can see here you are going to get only one answer because there was no option for us. You had this as x and this is 11 minus x. So, nahi ke plus kar sake kahin pe bhi. So, that's why it will be only one answer. So, there was sum number 11. Okay. So, that were the two sums which were based on the two-digit numbers. The next set of, there are three questions which are based on age. Okay. So these are the one which are based on age. So, whenever the sum is based on age, we will always make two columns. Okay. Let's see and see how to do this. So, you are on sum number 12. Okay, on sum number 12 now. Ritu is now 4 times as old as his brother Raju. In 4 years time, her age will be twice of Raju's age. What is the present age? So here we have got Ritu and Raju. Okay, so this is, we are always going to do it this way. Ritu, Raju. Now first we'll say about the present. What is the present condition? Ritu is now 4 times as old as a Raju. So if we take Raju to be as x, Ritu will be 4x. What is given here? Ritu is now 4 times as older as his brother Raju. That means if Raju is x years old, Ritu is 4x years old. If Raju is 2 years old, Ritu will be 8 years old. If Raju is 4 years old, she will be 16 years old. Right? So 4 times. Now what is given? In 4 years time. Now what we'll do here, understand this properly. It is given after 4 years. So we are not going to see anything what is given away. We just say what is given. In 4 years time. That means after 4 years. So here itself we'll take it as after 4 years. After 4 years. What will be this? This will become 4x plus 4. And this will become x plus 4. So after 4 years, what has happened? She has now become 4x plus 4 years old. And the Raju has become x plus 4 years old. Jo pehle 2 saal ka tha, abhi 6 saal ka ho gaya. Aur tabhi ye 8 saal ki thi, to abhi ye 12 saal ki ho jayegi. पहले ये 4 साल का था तो ये 16 साल की थी तो अभी ये 4 के पहले 8 साल का है तो ये 20 साल की हो जाएगी राइट सो दिस वे यू आर जस्ट गोइंग टू राइट दिस पार्ट नाउ वी आर नॉट सीइंग अप टिल नाउ व्हाट इज द कंडीशन गिवन टू यू व्हाट इज द कंडीशन नाउ गिवन दैट आफ्टर 4 इयर्स व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इट इज गिवन दैट हर एज विल बी ट्वाइस द राजूज एज दैट मींस दैट दिस इज ट्वाइस दिस सो वी हैव द इक्वेशन ओवर हियर दैट 4x + 4 इज इक्वल्स टू ट्वाइस x + 4 This is the important equation what we need to solve. So what has happened? We got first equation over here. Uske hisab se 4 saal ke baad ye ho gaya. Aur wo dono ka relationship kya diya hai? That it is going to be twice. Accordingly, you are going to solve this thing. So you get as 4x plus 4 is equals to 2x plus 8. So 4x minus 2x is equals to 8 minus 4. So 2x is equals to 4, x is equals to 4 upon 2, so x is equals to 2. Wow, so we just assume something and this is the answer also what we are getting. So here we can say, so present age of Raju is equals to 2 years and that of Ritu is equals to 4 into 2 is equals to 8 years. You can also cross check. 4 saal ke baad, his age will be 6. So his age, her age will be 12. And you can see, oh, double ho raha hai. 6 ka 12. So you are correct. So accordingly, you can see that the answers over here for the sum is 8 years and 2 years. So you need to find out because Ritu ka answer pehle dhoondna tha. So that's why age of Ritu is 8 years and age of Raju is 2 years. Always write it with the name rather than 8 years and 2 years वगैरह लिखने के बदले, so that you are sure that whatever answer you are given is correct. So this was sum number 12. I hope you understood this thing well. Now if you and not, then you can concentrate furthermore in the 13th sum so that you are more clearer on this. A father is 7 times as old as a son. So again the same way, father is 7 times old as son. So what we are having over here is the father and this is the son. If the father right now is so present, we have got this is, if the son is x years old, the father is 7x years old. What is going to happen? 2 years ago. Now it is 2 years ago. That means, 2 saal pehle ye kya tha? X minus 2 tha. Aur ye kitna tha? X 7x minus 2 tha. Okay? 2 years ago. Now, we are going to equate them. What is the given there? 2 years ago, father was 13 times as the son. So that's why 7x minus 2 is equals to 13 times the son's age. That was 2 years ago. So accordingly, you have 7x minus 2 is equals to 13x minus 26. So 7x minus 13x is equals to minus 26 plus 2. So minus 6x is equals to minus 24. So x is equals to minus 24 upon minus 6. So that will give me as 4. So x is equals to 4. So we have, you need to find out the present age of the, how old are they now? So that's the present age. So present age of son is equals to 4 years and father is 7 into 4 is equals to 28 years. Okay, 4 years and 28 years are the two answers which are over here. The son will be 4 years old and the father will be 28 years old. That was sum number 13. Okay, we now move on to sum number 14. Okay, let's see the sum number 14 again based on ages. Okay, sum number 14. The ages of Sona and Sonali are in the ratio of 5 is to 3. So they are already given here. So what we'll do is Sona and Sonali. It is given that present age. You got this is 5 is to 3. So this is nothing but 5x and this is 3x. Ratio tabhi bhi hoga. The numbers will be just multiplied by x. So it will be 5x and 3x. Now what has happened? 5 years hence. 5 years hence kya hoga? It will be 5 years hence. She will be 5x plus 5. And she will be 3x plus 5. And the condition is that the ratio of their ages is 10 upon 7. That means ratio kaise likhte hum log? So it will be 5x upon 5. Upon 3x plus 5 is equals to given as 10 upon 7. This is the equation. Ratios are always given as fractions. So this upon this is equals to 10 upon 7. That is what is given to us directly. So just cross multiply. So we get here 7, 5x plus 5 is equals to 10, 3x plus 5. So multiplying this way is 35x plus 35. Is equals to 30x plus 50. X on one side will be 35x minus 30x is equals to 50 minus 35. So that will give me as 5x is equals to 15. So x is equals to 15 upon 5. So x is equals to 3. Therefore, they need to know the present age of Sona and Sonali. So Sona's age is equals to 3 into 5 is equals to 15 years. Sonali is H. Is equals to 3 into 3. Is equals to 9 years. Sona is 15 years old and Sonali is 9 years old. So that was sum number 14. Okay, this was sum number 14. We now move on to sum number 15. Okay, the sum number 15 is based on some calculations about the days and the amount what she receives. So let's see. So we have sum number 15. An employee works in a company on a contract of 30 days on the condition that he receives rupees 200 for each day he works, and he will be fined 20 rupees for each day he is absent. He receives 3800 in all for how many days he remained absent. Okay, so we know that the contract is of 30 days. Okay, so total number of days is 30. So total days is equals to 30. Now let number of days absent is equals to X. So number of days present is equals to 30 minus X. 30 days total है, उसमें से अगर 5 दिन absent रहा, तो क्या हो गया, 30 minus 5, तो 25 days is present. This is exactly what we have done over here. If the person is going to be absent for X days, so present कितना रहेगा, 30 minus the absent days. Simple, right? Now, they are given that he is going to be paid 200 rupees for each day he is present. So, we can say, amount received for being present is equals to 30 minus X into 200, because 200 rupees is going to get per day, so that will be equal to 6000 minus 200X. That is the amount what he is going to receive. Okay. Now, amount which is going to be deducted for his being absent will be how much? So, amount deducted for absent is equals to 20 into X, because X days he was absent and 20 rupees per day is what he is going to be fined for that thing. So, accordingly, it will be rupees 20X. Now, what is the amount he is going to get? Jitna ye mila minus, see, he got this much rupees for being present, and he got deducted for this much rupees for him being absent, right? So this minus this is what is given as 3800. So we get over here as 6000 minus 200x minus 20x is equals to 3800. Amount paid for present minus amount paid for absent is equal to total amount received. So 6000 minus 200x minus 20x is equal to 3800. So 6000 minus 220x is equal to 3800 minus 220x is equal to 3800 minus 6000. So minus 220x is equals to minus 2200. So x is equals to minus 2200 upon minus 220. That will give me as 10. So x is equals to 10. So number of days absent is equals to 10 days. So the employee was absent for 10 days. That is what is the answer for sum number 15. Okay, so that was sum number 15. Okay, now we go move on to sum number 16. Okay, sum number 16 now. I have totally 300 rupees in coins of denomination 1, 2 and 5. So basically kya hai? I have got, yeh pe bahut saara chiller bada hua hai, change hai. That is 1 rupee coins, 2 rupee coins and 5 rupee coins. And the sum of all these total money is given to me as 300 rupees. Okay. The number of 2 rupee coins is 3 times the number of 5 rupee coins. The total number of coins is 160. Okay, so what is given is the number of 2 rupee coins is 3 times the 5 rupee coins. And if 5 rupee coins hoga maine x liya, so we'll take it this way. Let 5 rupee coins be x, therefore 2 rupee coins will be 3 times that. So 2 rupee coins will be 3x. Now total coins is equal to 160. They give me that they have got 160 coins together. All together they are 160 coins. That means 160 minus x minus 3x will give me the number of 1 rupee coins. Therefore, number of 1 rupee coins is equals to 160 minus x minus 3x, which is nothing but 160 minus 4x. Yani kya hua mere paas? I have got rupee 1 coin is equals to 160 minus 4x. Rupee 2 coins is equals to 3x. And rupee 5 coins is equals to x. This is the way I'm going to have the coins with me. Okay? This is just for your understanding. You may not write this thing. Now tell me, if I have got 10 coins of 1 rupee, what is the total number of rupees I've got? 1 into 10, then 10 rupees. So I know here that amount of rupee 1 is equals to 1 into 160 minus 4x is equals to rupees 160 minus 4x. Amount of rupees 2 is equals to 2 into 3x is equals to rupees 6x. And amount of rupees 5 is equals to 5 into x is equals to rupees 5x. See, I got 1 rupee ke itne coins, yani itna rupee ho gaya. 2 rupees ke sab 3 coin hai, to kitna rupee ho gaya? 6 rupees, aise hi. 3x hai, isliye 6 rupees, 6x. 5 rupees ke kitne coins hai? X coins hai, to total amount kitna ho gaya? 5x. Now I know that sum of this, this and this is 300 rupees because the total money I'm having is how much? 300. Because I got a total amount to be as 300, so that means that 5x plus 6x plus 160 minus 4x is equals to 300. 5 plus 6 is 11, 11 minus 4 is 7. So that will be 7x plus 160 is equals to 300. So 7x is equals to 300 minus 160. 7x is equals to 140. X is equals to 140 upon 7. So x is equals to 20. So what has happened now? That 5 rupee coins that I'm having is 20. So this way I'm just going to write the answers now directly. Rupee 5 coins is equals to x is equals to 20. Rupees 2 coins is equals to 3x. So 3 into 20, yeah, 3x. So 3 into 20 is 60 coins. So balance कितना बचा? 160 में से कर दो वो भी चलेगा, या तो इसमें आंसर निकालो तो भी चलेगा. रुपी 1 coins is equals to 160 minus 4x. 4x is nothing but 80. So 80 minus 160 is 80. So that's the answer for sum number 16. So how many coins of each denominator are with me? So I am having 5 rupees ka 20 coins, 2 rupees ka 60 coins, and 1 rupee ka 80 coins. So that is the answer as 80 coins of 1 rupee, 60 coins of 2 rupees, and 20 coins of 5 rupees to totally make it as 300 rupees. So there was a 16 sum. I'll continue from the 17 sum in the next video.